So my topic for today is what is tortious liability and to differentiate between intention, motive and malice. So these are all the things that we're going to cover today. What is a tort? What is liability? The foundation and mental element in tortious liability and what is motive, intention, malice and the differences between them. So first is what is a tort? So tort is an act or an omission that gives rise to injury or harm to another and amounts to a civil wrong for which courts impose liability. So injury here describes an invasion of any legal right, whereas harm describes a loss or detriment in fact that an individual suffers. So this includes negligence, invasion of privacy, financial losses, etc. So the primary aim of tort law is to provide relief to injured parties for harms caused by others and to impose liability on parties responsible for the harm and to deter others from committing harmful acts. So what is liability? In law, liable means responsible or answerable or legally obligated. So legal liability concerns both civil and criminal law and can arise from various areas of law such as torts. So in tort law, a person can be held liable for various acts such as negligence. So the determination of liability can be expressed by the maxim, ubi jus ibi remedia, where there is a right, there is remedy. In the context of torts, remedies are usually in the form of damages, which are monetary compensations. So the foundation of tortious liability. So the English law of tort contains a large and detailed body of rules defining with precise precision rights and duties and their limits for the purpose of public good. So there are the general rules which create liability and also the rules which provide immunity from liability, which are generally called the exceptions or justifications for tort. In between the two, the area of disputed cases is so vast that the courts have to play the role of an impartial umpire and decide the case either way, that is, hold the defendant liable or exempt him from liability. So the foundation of tortious liability has always remained a debated issue since the evolution of law of tort. So there are two conflicting views. One is law of tort that is propounded by Frederick Pollock and supported by Winfield, and the other is law of torts that's propounded by Salmond. So according to Winfield, every infringement right, that is injuria, will be a tort unless there's a legal justification for that injury. In other words, all unjustifiable violations of right will be regarded as tort. This is why the courts have the discretion to innovate new torts, taking into consideration the circumstances of the case before them. So Winfield opined that the categories of tort are never closed. So illustrating the point further, Winfield observed that the doctrine of absolute liability was incorporated as an important principle of law in tort through the House of Lords decision in Rylands versus Fletcher, handed down in 1868. Similarly, prior to the decision in Donahue versus Stevenson, the manufacturer of chattels was not held liable for the damages caused to the consumers for want of privity of contract between the two. And the same way in India also, in the case of MC Mehta versus Union of India, which is the oleum gas leak case, that was when absolute liability was made into a tort. So the other view regarding tortious liability, as expounded by Salmond, suggests that liability cannot extend beyond those torts which have already been registered as tort. If the defendant's wrongful act does not fall under any named or labeled tort, he cannot be held liable, thereby meaning that courts have the power vested in them to innovate new torts to innovate new torts to bring defendant within the fold of liability. But this view has not been supported by modern writers on the grounds that, like new crimes, evolution of new torts is inevitable within the development and progress of human society. So the likelihood of a new tort being included in the existing law of tort through judicial intervention cannot be ruled out. So in this context, the High Court of Madras in the Lala Panalal versus Kasturi Chand Ramji has observed that it would be undesirable to work out an exhaustive classification of dots and expect that the courts should not cross the limit of classification, nor would such a venture meet the interest of justice. So next is the mental element in tortious liability. So unlike crime, mens rea or a guilty mind is not an essential element of it. Motive is also generally not relevant in tort cases because the ultimate object of law of torts is redressal of wrong caused to the plaintiff by damages to be paid by the defendant. It's only in specific torts that the defendant's motive may be taken into consideration for determining his liability. And the reason being that the very nature of these torts is such that they cannot be committed without the presence of bad motive. In these cases, they can also be classified as a crime. So these specific torts that can also be classified as a crime are assault, battery, wrongful death. So next, we'll talk about the differences between motive, intention, and malice. So motive is the reason or reasons behind a person's actions. Example, his motive for stealing was to feed his family. So motive is generally irrelevant in tort law. It is usually taken into account in cases where the defendants and plaintiffs' arguments are evenly matched. In aggravated cases or offenses like fraud, violence, or cruelty, the defendant's improper motive will make it more likely that the plaintiff will receive damages for pain and suffering. The categories of torts where motive may be essential are deceit, defamation, malicious prosecution, etc., to name a few. Next is intention. So intention is the determination or plan to do a specific thing. For example, her intention was to learn Russian. Intention involves planning and forethought. It refers to a purposeful action and a conscious decision to perform an act that is forbidden by law. A tortious liability may arise irrespective of whether injury was intentional or not. However, there is a category of torts called intentional torts that exclusively take into consideration intention. These include battery, assault, trespass, and false imprisonment. Next is malice. Malice is a desire to harm others or to see others suffer, that is extreme ill will or spite. Example, you hate someone and want to seek revenge. So malice is when an act is done with bad intention. It is the intention to injure another party. And an act or statement becomes malicious if used for purposes other than those sanctioned by the law. Generally, malice is of no consequence in an action of tort. A finding of malice in civil law cases allows for the award of greater damages or exemplary damages. So difference between motive, intention, and malice. So motive alludes to the ulterior cause that induces a person to do or abstain from doing a particular act. Intention is a purposeful action and conscious decision to perform an act that is forbidden by law. And malice is wrongful intention to harm or deprive someone in an illegal or immoral way. So motive is the ultimate objective of an act. Intention is the immediate purpose of an act. And malice is a bad intention. Motive is implied. That means motive is the reason for doing something. And motive is related to some benefit or satisfaction which a person seeks. But this is not the case in intention and malice. Intention is expressed. It represents a commitment to carrying out an action or actions in the future. And malice is either expressed or implied. It is expressed when it is manifested in a deliberate intention to unlawfully take away the life of a human being. So motive is generally not required in torts. Intention is exclusively considered under a separate category of torts called intentional torts. And malice can only be used to obtain greater or exemplary damages. Thank you.